Wichita, Kansas, the 1992 Miss USA pageant. Starring 51 of the most outstanding young women in the USA. With your host, Dick Clark. Co-host, hard copy anchor, Terry Murphy. Special commentator, former Miss USA, Deborah Shelton. The reigning Miss USA, Kelly McCarty. And saluting America's Armed Forces, United States Air Force Academy Cadet Corral, and Sabre Drill Team. And now, here are the 51 contestants for the title of Miss USA 1992.
Thank you very, very much, and good evening. It's so nice to be right here in the middle of so many beautiful people, and your state costumes are fabulous. You look great, just really great. You know, you agree? You bet. You know, the Miss USA pageant is back in the Century 2 Convention Center here in Wichita for the third year in a row, and we thank you so much for your hospitality. It gets to be, it's just like home here in Kansas, and we thank you so much for your hospitality. Nice to be back. You know, the spirit of competition is in the air with the Olympic Winter Games beginning tomorrow in France, and we're about to have some pretty tough competition right here on this stage. There are 51 dynamic, energetic, beautiful, brainy, very nervous young women here, and there's no way in the world I'm going to keep track of them all by myself. So to help me, here is the co-anchor of Hard Copy. Please welcome Ms. Terry Murphy.
Good evening, everyone.
And welcome, Terry. It's nice to see you.
It's great to be here, Dick.
Now, is it true you have been trying to get on this stage here of the Miss USA pageant since 1969?
Uh-oh, you've been digging into my past.
I've not only been digging, I have photographic evidence. Folks, check this out. This is Miss Ohio, USA, 1969, a vision of loveliness.
Oh, no, can you believe that hair?
What have you got in there?
I don't know, I never checked.
But You never got to compete in the Miss USA pageant?
No, I became ill after I arrived in Miami, so they had to send the second runner-up for Miss Ohio to compete for me.
This is a very touch. Oh, yes, that's a real awe. Well, it would make you feel a little better. But the staff gathered, look, we've created this for
yes!
you. You finally got it. Your Miss Ohio USA pageant. There you go,
look,
from 1969. All right.
It looks now that I am all ready for the evening gown competition.
Forget evening gowns. First thing is swimsuit competition.
Oh, no way.
Uh-uh.
You can have this back.
You chicken.
I think I'm going to let Miss Ohio 1992 fill in for me.
Well, I tell you what, you're going to be up in the anchor booth?
That's right. I'm actually going to be up in the anchor booth with Deborah Shelton.
And delivering the real hard copy to this audience?
That's right. Deborah is a former Miss USA, and as two pageant veterans, we are prepared to tell all.
I tell you what, hang on to this just in case.
I'll be standing by.
And have a good trip to the booth.
Thanks. Good
ladies
luck, ladies.
Ladies and gentlemen, Terry Murphy. See you later. All right. You know, these ladies just didn't jump off the bus out there in these fabulous costumes and walk into the Century 2 Convention Center tonight. They have already participated in a week of preliminary competition to determine who our 11 semifinalists will be. During the preliminaries, our judges have scored the candidates in three events: the swimsuit competition, in which they modeled identical suits; the evening gown competition, with the ladies wearing gowns of their own choice; and the interview competition, where each judge had the pleasure of talking individually with each contestant. Now, the scores from the three events were added together and averaged for the contestants' preliminary ranking. And you'll see the three scores these young ladies received in the events now in the traditional parade of states, along with a visual reminder of how the contestants looked in the preliminaries. Now, as they introduce themselves and tell you a little bit about their plans for the future, see if you can guess who will win the award for Best State Costume. And now, here are the 51 candidates for the title of Miss USA 1992, starting with the contestants from the Midwest, Miss Kansas. Miss Michigan.
I'm a senior at Michigan State University, majoring in psychology and planning a career in public relations. I'm Lainey Lou Howard.
Miss Nebraska.
Now a rural emergency room doctor, I plan to open a rehabilitation clinic for the handicapped. From Omaha, Nebraska, I'm Dr. Gina Blum.
Miss Minnesota.
A special ed major at the University of Minnesota, I plan on a career working with disabled children. From Minneapolis, I am Amber Rue.
Miss Wisconsin.
I'm Kelly Bright. After receiving my master's from the University of Wisconsin, I plan to become a network anchorwoman.
Miss Missouri.
After completing my master's degree in education, I plan to teach. I am Tanya Snigas from Springfield, Missouri.
Miss Iowa.
I'm Pam Patrick, a university student and professional singer. My dream is to someday own a recording studio that's state-of-the-art.
Miss Ohio.
Now a buyer for a major retailer, I plan to own my own store someday, featuring designs by me, Courtney Faber.
Miss North Dakota.
As a diamond consultant, my intention is to become a public relations director for the diamond industry. I'm Tammy Flatham.
Miss Illinois.
I'm Leilani Magnuson, and after finishing my degree in communications, I plan to own and operate my own broadcast facility.
Miss South Dakota.
I'm a senior majoring in accounting and math and plan to become an actuary. From Sioux Falls, I am Sean Frerick.
Miss Indiana.
I'm a social anthropology major, and after graduation, it's a career in public relations for me. I'm Heather Gray.
And now, the contestants from the South, beginning with Miss Texas.
Kids are where it's at for me, and as a pre-med student, I plan to pursue a career in obstetrics. From Fort Worth, Texas, I'm Katie Young.
Miss Georgia.
I'm a college graduate planning to get my master's in political science. From Atlanta, Georgia, home of the 1996 Olympics, I'm Jennifer Rogers.
Miss Oklahoma.
I am now a professional singer and hope to eventually become a manager in the entertainment field. From Lawton, Oklahoma, I'm Maya Walker.
Miss South Carolina.
I'm a student at Clemson University aiming to complete my doctorate degree in English. From Charleston, I am Audra Wallace.
Miss Virginia.
I dance with the Virginia Ballet Company, and my goal now is to create my own multicultural dance company. I am Brandy Bator.
Miss Florida.
After graduation, I plan a career designing one-of-a-kind yacht interiors. From Coral Gables, I'm Sharon Belden.
Miss Arkansas.
I'm Jonna Garner, a senior liberal arts major from Crossett, Arkansas, and my future plans include a career in public relations.
Miss North Carolina.
After finishing my master's, I hope to become a leader in the health field by hosting my own fitness show. I'm Tess Elliott.
Miss Kentucky.
Now a professional model, I aspire to a career in the entertainment field. I'm Angela Hines from Maysville, Kentucky.
Miss Alabama.
I'm Candace Branagh, Jr. at
University majoring in communication, and I'm looking forward to a career as a network anchor woman.
Miss District of Columbia.
I'm an insurance agent with a career looking forward to marketing. Home of the Super Bowl champion Redskins, I'm Wanda Jones.
Miss Maryland.
I am the owner of a full-service beauty salon and hope to combine the titles of wife, mother, and career woman. I'm Renee Repstock.
Miss Delaware.
I'm Julie Griffith from Wilmington, Delaware, currently modeling. I look forward to a career in acting, and who knows, maybe even the Academy Award.
Miss Mississippi.
From Jackson, I'm Tammy Johnson. After graduation from Mississippi State University, I plan to have eventually a successful design firm.
Miss Tennessee.
Now that I have my bachelor's degree, I will be attending law school and hope someday the sign on my door will read, the Honorable Natalie Bray.
Miss Louisiana.
Now an environmental reporter, I hope to one day own my own environmental publication. From the Bayou Country, I'm Christy Saylor.
Miss West Virginia.
Now a master's degree candidate, I plan to become a university professor. From Parkersburg, West Virginia, I am Vicki Myers.
And now the contestants from the Northeast, beginning with Miss New York.
I'm a professional model with an eye on Hollywood and a career in acting. I reside in Peekskill, New York. I'm Christine Beechef.
Miss Rhode Island.
Buenas noches, amigos. Mi nombre es Yvette Hernandez, and I'm looking forward to a career in tourism, which enables me to use my bilingual skills.
Miss New Hampshire.
I'm Rebecca Lee Lake, studying business and economics at the University of New Hampshire, and I look forward to a career as a CPA.
Miss Connecticut.
Besides developing a modeling agency, I am also a member of the Connecticut Army National Guard. I am Catherine Sanchez.
Miss New Jersey.
An engineering student at Rutgers University, I plan to use my degree to make a difference in the American workplace. I'm Kathy Kasprack.
Miss Vermont.
I'm Bonnie Kittredge, a sophomore at the University of Vermont. I'd like to be our generation's Barbara Walters.
Miss Massachusetts.
Hi, my name is Christine Edison, a scientific programmer at MIT. My next goal is to complete a PhD in math education.
Miss Maine.
I hold one degree from Tufts University, and I'm now working towards my fellowship in the Society of Actuaries. I'm Linda Keene.
Miss Pennsylvania.
After completing my education, I aspire to a successful stage, film, and television career. From Pennsylvania, I'm Catherine Weber.
And now, the contestants from the Northwest, here's Miss Montana.
After completing my degree in physical therapy, I hope to make you comfortable in my own health and fitness spa. From Bozeman, Montana, I'm Joy Estrada.
Miss Oregon.
I hold a degree in psychology from Oregon State University and plan on getting my doctorate degree. I'm Carrie Jean House.
Miss Idaho.
A recent college graduate, I plan to use my degree to open up my own advertising agency. I'm Cheryl Myers from Boise, Idaho.
Miss Wyoming.
My goal is to someday have a health club resort in the wide open beauty of Wyoming. From Green River, I'm Lisa Postel.
Miss Alaska.
From Anchorage, I'm Kelly Quirk, a student at the University of Alaska. My future plans include a thriving physical therapy practice.
Miss Washington.
My goal is to obtain my PhD in psychology and then help children live happy, healthy lives. I'm Stina McQuinn.
And now, the contestants from the Southwest, starting with Miss Utah.
I'm a college student preparing for medical school and hope to become a psychiatrist. From Salt Lake City, Utah, I'm Michelle Mickelson.
Miss Colorado.
After completing my PhD in education, I plan to become a university professor training others to teach. I'm Laura DeWild.
Miss Hawaii.
From Honolulu, I'm Heather Hayes. Completing my master's degree and hosting my own network show are my goals.
Miss New Mexico.
After completing my degree, I plan to become a CPA and someday start my own accounting firm. From Alamogordo, I'm Charlotte Holland.
Miss Nevada.
From Las Vegas, I'm Alicia Prentice. After completing my education at UNLV, I plan to pursue a career as a professor of art.
Miss Arizona.
To give you the evening news as a news anchor woman is my goal. From Mesa, Arizona, I'm Dennis Shepard.
Miss California.
A pre-law major at Pepperdine University, I see my future as an attorney and advocate for children's rights. I am Shannon Marketic.
And there they are, ladies and gentlemen. When we return, we'll reveal our 11 semifinalists.
While we're here, I want to stop by the
T-O-Y-S-T-O-R-E. Susie's B-I-R-T-H-D-A-Y is coming up, and I thought we could get her P-R-E-S-E-N-T today.
Okay.
Why don't you take the kids somewhere for L-U-N-C-H, and I'll meet you later.
Well, W-H-E-R-E.
Well, how about McDonald's? I mean, M-C-D-O-N-A-L-D-S.
Through the years, the mothers of America have had a kind of medical training.
Next.
They've learned from countless doctors and pharmacists that the way to take care of a cough is with Robitussin. And now at home, the mothers of America are putting this advice to work.
Next.
Robitussin, recommended by Dr. Mom. Which Robitussin is right for you? Ask your doctor or pharmacist. And now there's Robitussin cough drops. Cough drops from the cough experts.
My health club always had Pert Plus in the locker room. It cleans, conditions. It's great. And one day they switched. This one said it had conditioner in it, but my hair told a different story.
Some two-in-ones don't lather as well or leave hair feeling as clean. Others don't fully condition. But Pert Plus's microbead conditioner leaves hair clean and completely conditioned.
So now when I go to my club, my Pert Plus goes with me.
Pert Plus. There's no two-in-one like this one.
Welcome back. This is our anchor booth where we're going to be keeping an eye on all the action for you tonight. Did you pick the winner of the state costume competition? It was Miss Indiana in her Sunrise on the Plains costume. She wins a cash prize and a trophy, but this award does not count in the scoring for tonight's competition. For the second year, former Miss USA Deborah Shelton is here as a special commentator. Hi, Deborah.
Hi, Terry.
No one knows better what it's like to compete for the Miss USA crown than someone who's won it. Deborah, you spent the past week interviewing the contestants. What is your impression?
I tell you, Terry, this is an incredible group. They are not only beautiful, but very brainy. 98% of them have attended college. The overall group grade point average is 3.3, which is a B+, and there are four straight A students here.
It's an extraordinary group this year. I know Miss Nebraska is a practicing physician.
Right. We have cum laude graduates, magna cum laude, summa cum laude, pre-med, pre-law, math, physics, and engineering major. Just a note of warning, Terry, the most popular career choice here is broadcasting. I think there are eight of them after your job.
I already hear their footsteps. Who do you think now will make it into the group of 11 semifinalists?
I had hives last night because I could only get it down to 16. The writers were making me choose, but I think Arizona, articulate, intelligent. Georgia's that all-around student. Texas, poised, incredible, carries herself well. Kentucky's a doll. Louisiana's a great joke teller, and
you're
she's
right.
Gorgeous.
You've got a lot of choices. Good luck in narrowing it down. By the way, the contestants and judges can't hear what Deborah and I are saying up here, so it won't really influence the scoring at all. And speaking of scoring, let's see now the top scores in the preliminary competitions which took place this week. Take a look at all of these nines. I feel like we're in the Olympics already. Texas took the swimsuit division, 9.3, followed very closely, though, by Kansas and Virginia. In the interview part of the competition, Kentucky was the best talker there, 9.686, but look how close Georgia is, and Kansas bringing up third position. In evening gown, Texas again with a 9.343, Kentucky behind 9.143, and look at this, we have a tie for first place, an exact tie, 9.1. Boy, is this a close race. It gives us some idea of the leading contenders, but I know the contestants have a real insider's view of who's hot. Deborah, who do the girls think will make the 11 semifinals?
I'm going to tell you how tough this is. Usually the contestants have one girl way out in a big lead, but this year, out of 51 contestants, Terry, I have 21 answers. Miss Nevada won, but only by 3 votes. Miss Michigan followed her, and everyone else was right thereafter.
It just goes to show you what an incredible group of young ladies
wonderful.
This is. And just to remind you that this is really a competition, Danny Sheridan, the odds maker for USA Today, has Texas and California as favorites at 5-1 odds. Well, now that we've heard from all the experts, let's go back to the stage and see who's right.
You know, the Miss USA pageant begins with literally thousands of young women entering local pageants all around the country. And from all of those thousands, we must now narrow it down to just 11 semifinalists. Later, we'll choose 6 finalists, and then the final 3 contestants for Miss USA. During the Parade of States, you saw each contestant's scores in 3 preliminary competitions, swimsuits, interviews, and evening gowns. Let me pick up the results now. Thank you, sir. Now, we've added and averaged these composite scores, and the 11 highest scores determine our semifinalists. You'll see the composite preliminary scores on the screen. Ladies, take a deep breath. You ready? All right. I'll call these out in random order. The semifinalists are Miss Arizona, Dana Shepherd.
Dennis is one of those broadcasting majors you mentioned, Deborah. We expected at least one of them would make it.
Miss Georgia, Jennifer Brodgers.
Well, this is no surprise. I picked Jennifer because she finished second in the preliminary interviews and third in gowns.
Miss North Carolina, Tess Elliott.
Tess said she used to be called Tess the Mess as a kid, but this ought to retire that nickname, don't you think?
Give it up.
Miss California, Shannon Marketic.
Wow. That's one for the odds makers and me. Shannon was a favorite, and she's in the semifinals. She was also Miss Photogenic.
That's right.
Miss Kansas, Kimberly Gearens.
What an uproar. Kansas won last year, and now Kimberly is in the running for 1992.
Miss Louisiana, Christy Saylor.
An admirer has been sending Christy flowers every day for the past 2 weeks. Maybe it brought her luck.
Maybe.
There are 5 left, one of which is Miss South Carolina, Audra Wallace.
Deborah, this is a surprise because Audra was so quiet at first. Yeah. Then she hit the stage in the preliminaries, remember? And she just blossomed.
Miss Virginia, Brandi Bottorff.
Wow, another girl from the South. I've been counting. Brandi's number 5.
3 remain. Miss Alabama, Candace Brown.
Uh-oh, here comes another broadcast major, Deborah, and Candace is the 6th contestant from the South.
She has my birthday.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Miss Kentucky, Angela Hines.
All right, I'm 2 out of 3 with my picks. I knew Angela would make it, and that's 7. Come on, 7 ladies from the South.
One more name. Miss Texas, Katie Young.
Deborah, you and the odds makers both picked Katie, and why not? Texas has won Miss USA a record 6 times. Can you believe it?
Ladies and gentlemen, the 11 semifinalists for the title of Miss USA 1992.
Gonna get exciting now. There they are, the lucky 11 out of all the thousands who began months ago, and there are thousands here who will be cheering them on, as you can hear. The odds makers have California and Texas as the favorites, and they both made it. Now, how did the contestants do with their poll?
Neither Michigan nor Nevada made it, and I was surprised because Nevada was Miss Congeniality.
Well, no one can predict what the judges will do. The composite scores you saw earlier will be erased now, and the 11 semifinalists will begin tonight's competition with a clean slate.
Yes, and our audience at home will see every bit of that competition live tonight.
We'll begin the swimsuit competition in a few moments. Deborah, who are the top contenders in this division?
I think the models should do well here. You know, Kentucky has been a professional model for 2 years. Texas model to pay her way through school, and Miss Louisiana's been teaching modeling.
And I hear Kentucky has already been in nearly 100 pageants.
That's right, and she is gorgeous. But you know, these girls are so tan, toned, cut, buffed, athletic bodies, it's not easy. They've been in the gym every day.
No kidding. Now, if you want to see the results of several thousand hours of working out, stay tuned. The Catalina Swimsuit Competition is coming up next, right after this.
This is about promises kept. If we promise it gives your skin incredible moisture replenishment.
It will.
If we promise visible smoothing of tiny lines.
It delivers.
If we promise it works like the fluid in young skin, So when it smooths on,
it sinks in every time.
So skin looks radiantly younger.
It has to.
Without question. Oil of Olay. We keep our promise to young skin. Original and sensitive.
This brings back memories. Oh, these are great.
What's this remind you of?
Tastes like vanilla,
huh? Senior trip.
Paris.
The cafe!
Yeah!
Rich, creamy tasting coffee with a hint of vanilla flavor. New French Vanilla Cafe.
I love this coffee.
New from General Foods International Coffees.
I loved that waiter. Jean-Luc.
My best friend and I went out last night with our brand new perms. Well, she had gone to the salon and spent way too much. And I had gotten an Ogilvy home perm. People kept saying to me, oh, your hair is gorgeous. But nobody really said anything to her. The Precisely Right home perm, it's got automatic shut-off timing. I couldn't have overdone it. I couldn't have underdone it. It's perfect. I'm glad I didn't go with her to the salon.
So now that you got a beautiful perm, what do you get? Ogilvy Hot Oil for permed hair. 1 minute once a week helps keep your great-looking perm looking great. Ogilvy Hot Oil. You got it right? Now keep it right.
Home. That's where the dream begins. The dream of Olympic competition. Because for every young athlete who wakes up early to practice, there's a mom and dad who wake up even earlier to get them there. So when you watch the 1992 Olympic Winter Games on CBS, remember, that's not just America's team out there. That's somebody's kid.
Share a moment with the world.
We're about to begin tonight's competition. We'd like you to meet the nine people who will choose Miss USA 1992. Our distinguished panel of judges and audience, I would ask you please to hold your applause until the end. Let's meet our first judge. He's a nightclub entrepreneur and a country music living legend with 17 number one hits and a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. He's Mickey Gilley. Her Cloutier agency has styled everything from Demi Moore's controversial Vanity Fair cover to the ever-changing looks of Madonna. She's Chantal Cloutier. He's a novelist, television and screenwriter, and a media commentator who also contributes to People magazine. He's David Marlowe. She starred in the film The Forbidden Dance Lombada, won a Golden Eagle Award for her role on General Hospital, and she's our own Miss USA 1985, Laura Herring. Hill is the pioneer of artistic skating. He thrilled the world at the 76 Olympics with his medal-winning performances. He is ice skating star Taller Cranston. She covered the celebrity beat for Entertainment Tonight, has her own line of skincare products, and is the fashion and beauty correspondent for the home show. She's Paula McClure. His creations dot the Las Vegas landscape, and every year the world waits to see his latest work, those award-winning floats in the Rose Parade. He's designer Raul Rodriguez. She starred in Head of the Class and as Bill Cosby's daughter in Ghost Dad. You'll see her in the upcoming TV film, The Hank Gather Story. She's Kimberly Russell. He's a 15-year veteran of the NFL and his team's most valuable player in 1990, the starting quarterback for the Kansas City Chiefs, Steve DeBerg, and these are our judges.
When the Winter Olympics begin on CBS tomorrow, the judges for the ice skating competition will be using a scoring system similar to ours. As each contestant competes, the judges enter a score ranging from 1.0 to a high of 9.99 into their computer terminals. You'll see the judges' names and scores, then the highest, low, and lowest scores are eliminated, and the remaining scores are averaged like this. Each contestant's average scores in the swimsuit, interview, and evening gown competition are added, and the top six composite scores determine the six finalists. Now, let's get started with tonight's competition.
Thank you, Deborah. Now, this is the first of our three semifinal competitions this evening. Now, the swimsuit competition is certainly about poise and beauty, but it's also about health and physical fitness. We calculated that our 51 contestants work out for a total of 24,752 hours a year. And when you see our semifinalists, I think you'll agree that it was time well spent. Now, as they model swimsuits from Catalina and shoes by Federico Leone, we've asked each young lady to tell us a little bit about herself, and we begin with Miss Arizona.
I think the best word that describes me is real. I feel that as Dana's shepherd, what you see is really what you get. and I'm really happy being me, and I don't like to put on any kind of facade. I just like to be a real person.
Miss Georgia.
Well, when I was in college, I was in Berlin when the wall came down. And it definitely was the most wonderful experience of my life because I learned a lot about freedom. I learned a lot about fighting for what you want and what you believe in. And they wanted the freedom that I had. And it's very, my freedom is very precious to me now.
Miss North Carolina.
Well, I describe myself as being very adventurous. I like to try anything once. I like to scuba dive, I skydive. My philosophy is that you can't really determine when or where or how you'll leave this place, so I like to live it up while I'm here and make every day count.
Miss California.
I think that I was a tomboy growing up, very much a daddy's girl. I remember things like I learned how to drive on a tractor out in a pasture, and my parents and I, we went scuba diving and horseback riding, we herded cattle and went rock climbing. And I think that even though I'm on my own now, I think that my fondest memories will always be of having a close family growing up.
Miss Kansas.
The best part about being Miss Kansas has been my ability to go around talking to the children in the state of Kansas, telling them that saying no to drugs is the cool thing to do and the right thing to do, and that they can do whatever they want as long as they set their goals high and keep a positive outlook on life.
Miss Louisiana.
My most memorable summer was definitely last summer when one of my friends and I backpacked through Europe. We traveled through 7 countries in 30 days. And we left our makeup behind, met lots of new friends, saw many interesting sights, and learned more about how other cultures live. It was an incredible experience, and I'll never forget it.
Miss South Carolina.
The best summer I've ever had in my life was the summer of 1991. It's because I was taking 16 hours in summer school. I was working with children with disabilities at Camp Hope, and I was also participating in a part-time job where I had basically no free time, and the free time I did have, I used for volunteer work. And I loved it because it showed me that I can achieve, I made Dean's List, and I could also give of myself.
Miss Virginia.
Well, I first stepped into ballet shoes at the age of 3 and have been dancing ever since. I hope to one day own my own multi-ethnic dance company that gets the opportunity to perform all over the world. From there, we'll just have to see. But my number one inspiration has been Mikhail Baryshnikov, and I hope to one day captivate my audiences the way that he has for so many years.
Miss Alabama.
There are truly a lot of great people out there, but my mom is the most inspiring person that I've ever met. She was very poor when she was growing up, and now she's very successful. And just being around all that, the positive energy and enthusiasm, is just very inspiring to me.
Miss Kentucky.
I definitely would say I'm a competitive person. I've been raised in a family of athletes. My father was a basketball coach, and I have 3 athletic brothers. And they always taught me to have faith, be confident, and also, I mean, first and foremost, be a good winner and be a good loser. And now that I'm adult, I use these techniques every day.
Miss Texas.
My favorite movies are definitely the older black and white movies, especially if Katharine Hepburn's in them. I think that she's a great actress, but I also admire her as a woman. She made a difficult decision in choosing career over family, and I can't say that I would have made the same decision, but I respect her for that.
Thank you, ladies. That completes the Catalina Swimsuit Competition for Miss USA 1992.
What a fabulous
group, and I can promise you there's no cottage cheese on those thighs. They ought to sell several thousand gym memberships first thing tomorrow morning. Let's recap now the scoring in this competition. First with Alabama, 9.479. Coming in second, 9.473. Kansas, 9.469. As you can see, way on down, you range from 9.4 to 9. This is a very close competition. The winner of the swimsuit competition, Miss Alabama, wins this beautiful Oroforce Crystal Trophy. Remember, this competition counts for one-third of their score. The next third will come from the interview competition, which begins in a few moments. Now, while the girls are changing into their After Five dresses, let's take a moment to see what fun they've been having here in Wichita and around the state of Kansas for the past 2 weeks. Meeting in the heartland of America gave the Miss USA delegates the opportunity to make new friends and enjoy a favorite event in Kansas, the rodeo. Ride 'em cowboy. The real fun began when they were invited to meet some of the younger cowboys, and there were a few cuties. And they're off. Hang on. Well, there was nothing a little TLC didn't fix. Off to do a little sightseeing in Kansas. The first stop was the Eisenhower Museum, where the delegates learned about one of America's great military and political leaders. Checking the wardrobe of the former first ladies, it was fun to see the changes in fashion and, of course, the hemlines. At the state capitol, the delegates brought gifts from all over the USA to auction for charity. The bidding was fierce. The following morning, some of the delegates went for driving lessons at Heartland Racetrack. Ladies, start your engines. Fasten your seatbelts. To the salt mines they went. It's kind of spooky 600 feet underground, but you wouldn't believe what's stored down here. It was fun finding the original footage of some of Hollywood's great films. From the depths of the earth to the final frontier they went. Miss Georgia will never be the same. The Cosmosphere in Hutchison offers a truly out-of-this-world experience. And a little adjustment for an evening out in space. From choosing the right brushes to getting a new look, celebrity stylist Bryant Renfro spent time with the delegates giving hair care tips, including how to use Ogilvy hot oil treatments for permed hair. Thank you, Ogilvy, for a great time and some good advice. A surprise visit to Starkey Development Center, which employs the handicapped, brought smiles to some of the delegates' fans. A surprise cake baked at the center was shared by all. Mmm, good to the last bite. Bending, twisting, and stretching in their Catalina activewear, the girls tried to keep up with Olympic gold medalists Bart Conner and Nadia Comaneci. At a karaoke sing-along, some real talent was discovered. Background support by Mayor Knight. What a great time they had. Wichita is a great host city. And as you can see, Kansas is a state full of surprises. The girls have really had a ball here. The next competition is the one that really scares a lot of contestants, the interviews.
Ooh, and the contestants have no idea what question Dick is going to ask. So they're back in the dressing room right now trying to touch up mascara with very shaky hands.
And that's not easy to do. Deborah, we know Miss Kentucky was first in the preliminary interview competition. Who else do you think will do well?
I think Arizona's one to watch. She's a broadcast major. She's on the dean's list. She's already been an intern at a CBS affiliate, and Miss Alabama's also a broadcast major.
And California has already written a book at the tender age of 22.
She is a top student, wants to be an attorney for abused children, and her long-range goal is to be a Supreme Court judge.
I'm sure she can hold forth on any subject.
You bet. And we can't forget Kansas with all this hometown support.
Wasn't that great? Okay, it's going to get intense now. We will be back with the interviews right after this.
Loving care says wash away clay, do it change your color. Just keep it soft and shining forever.
Wash gray out of your life with Loving Care, the no peroxide way to gently wash away gray and make you look like you again.
Loving Care says, what do you say? Wash away gray, never go gray, wash away gray.
Look at Chipco. These new Pampers Phases sure make walking easy.
Introducing Pampers Phases, the first developmental diapers for walkers.
Pampers holds four times more than the average walker wet because they're super absorbent, yet they're extra narrow between the legs, not wide like this other leading diaper. So walking's a breeze.
New Pampers Phases, the first developmental diapers for dry and happy babies phase after phase.
See Sunday's paper for the Wheel of Fortune Watch and Win game. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited.
The Miss USA pageant will continue.
Stay tuned!
Hi, I'm Paula Zahn. While you're enjoying Miss USA, we are here in the French Alps, where tomorrow night the Olympic Games will begin with the opening ceremony. It will have everything from rollerbladers to bungee jumpers, and it promises to be like nothing you've ever seen before. And Sunday night, the start of figure skating, featuring the stunning world pairs champions, Mishkutonok and Dimitriev. And the American upstarts, our national champions, Collar Urbanski and Rocky Marvel, a waitress and a truck driver. Also Sunday night, the men's downhill. And as you can see from these test runs, it could be the most spectacular Olympic downhill ever. Later tonight, Tim McCarver will tell you about America's gold medal front runner, who the Champaign police call their favorite speeder.
This is CBS.
You know, I always thought that taking something like this was, a sign of weakness. And with my business, I've just been a bundle of nerves.
It's a mild medication for anxiety. You're not alone.
What if I become dependent?
Well, everybody's different, but for now...
Personal questions, private conversations. At CVS, you can talk to your pharmacist one-to-one.
This shouldn't be a part of your anxiety.
CVS.
What are you afraid of? My son asked me. They're only little bugs. Well, I don't like creepy, crawly little bugs, and the thought of them getting on me used to be a real fear. A phobia, I guess. But hey, I'm not the only one. Nearly three-quarters of us have some kind of phobia. Heights, snakes, dentists, bugs. So what can we do? Channel 10 News will focus on how to understand and overcome our fears with some fascinating and insightful tips. Phobias, what are you afraid of? Tonight on Channel 10 News, where our focus is on you.
Tyson takes the stand to tell his side of the story tonight at 11.
Now, imagine you're walking down the street, you meet a friend, and you stop and chat for a couple of minutes. There's nothing too unusual about that. But now imagine that millions of people are watching you and nine judges are scoring you on how well you carry on that conversation. That is what is about to happen to our semifinalists in the interview competition. Now, these interviews are unrehearsed. The contestants are being judged on poise, intelligence, personality, and the content of their answers. And we'll begin with Miss Arizona. Dana Shepherd is 24. She's a recent graduate of Arizona State University with a degree in communications. And let me see. You have described yourself in your biography as a woman of the 90s. What did you mean by that?
Well, I think in the 80s, a lot of women wanted to just have a career and a family. But I think a woman of the 90s, she just assumes that she's going to have a family and a career both. And I think that's why I consider myself a woman of the 90s. Having an example of my parents, I just took it for granted that I was going to have both and combine them with a lot of quality.
All right. Now, you said you wanted to combine a career in broadcasting and marriage, and your parents have been married for 27 years. Your dad's a marriage counselor. If ever you got married and had a little trouble, as all people do, would you go to him for advice?
Yes, I would. he's always taught me, though, since I was small, what to look for in a husband, and that he must be a good friend and kind and a gentle person. And I think if I look for those traits, hopefully I won't be having any problems.
All right. Would you step over here, please? And the judges will now give you a score. Miss Arizona. Next is Miss Georgia. Jennifer Prodgers, who's 22 years of age, a recent college graduate from Atlanta with degrees in German and political science. Now that you've graduated, what are your plans?
I'd like to go back and get my political science master's and eventually teach in a high school or middle school.
You said you were in the Berlin area when the wall came down, but things have changed over there now. The Soviet story is very different. What do you think the next major story is going to be?
I hope it's the environment, and I think that we really need to look at this issue. We have a huge hole in our ozone, and that's the basis of life right there. So I hope it is the environment.
I want to ask you about that wall coming down. Was that an impressive occasion?
Oh, was it ever.
Did you save a piece of it?
You better believe it. I have four pieces, all with graffiti on them.
Where do you keep them?
Well, they're in this bottom drawer, and they're wrapped in tissue paper, and then they're in a box, so they're protected.
Valuable piece of history. Would you step over here for our judges, please? This is Miss Georgia. Next is Miss North Carolina. This is Tess Elliott, who's 22 years of age, a recent graduate of the University of North Carolina. Skydiver, scuba dives, parasails, windsurfs. Is there anything you haven't tried yet?
No, I don't think there's anything except my next goal is to hang glide over the Grand Canyon. Thought that would be fun.
Better you than me. I don't know when it was, last summer sometime, you were a door-to-door salesman selling books. Is that true?
Yes, I sure was. It was an internship I was involved in college. It was an internship where you got selected, and then you took off the day school got out, and you hiked off to another state, usually on the other side of the United States, and you sold books door-to-door. So I was in about over 4,000 different homes over the three summers.
I've done that sort of thing. It's tough. What did you learn?
I sure learned a lot. I learned mostly to control my emotions and not let my emotions control me. And also I learned just to never quit. We worked 80-hour weeks, so you can imagine that I gave up my summer vacations. And I learned mostly just to never quit, to always try, because I did very well with the company.
Good moral of the story. Would you step over here for just a moment for the judges? This is Miss North Carolina. Next is Miss California, Shannon Marketic. She's got an academic scholarship at Pepperdine University, wants to be an attorney, child advocacy. You're writing a book on raising parents. Who's it for?
It's called Raising Parents, and it's actually for parents who are raising kids. And it's kind of a young person's perspective on how a parent can be more effective.
You hope to be a parent yourself someday?
I sure do.
Are you going to be tough or easy?
Well, I think that I'll be what I need to be at that time. I'll be tough when it comes to discipline, but in a loving way.
Now, if you were looking around for a husband right now, I don't know whether he's in this audience or not, what would you be looking for?
Well, I'd like him to have mastered the art of monogamy, and I think that's really important. And it's hard to find.
You mean the guys you're running into are not into that?
Well, California. I'd like him to be spiritually grounded, and I'd like him to know that marriage is a very sacred thing, and I'd like him to know that everlasting commitment is really important.
Thank you very much. If you will hold for just a moment here, that's Miss California. Next is Miss Kansas, Kimberly Guerin, is right here from Wichita, senior at Wichita State University, majoring in radio and television. What are your plans after graduation?
After graduation, I hope to get a career in the entertainment business, whether it be in radio or TV, and hopefully I'll be as successful as Lisa Gibbons.
Is that your aim? You want to be an anchor person?
Yes, I do. I prefer the entertainment industry, whether it be in broadcasting or sitcom or soap opera actress.
You got a lot of choices out there, lady. Let me ask you a little bit about Kansas. Everybody talks about the Wizard of Oz. There is no such place, but isn't there a place dedicated to Dorothy's home here?
Yes, it is. It's in Kelly McCarty's hometown of Liberal, Kansas. And I went to a state basketball tournament there, and I visited the little home, and it had a yellow brick road, and it was really cute, and it was a lot of fun.
Everybody's invited?
Everybody's invited. So everyone come to Wichita, Kansas, and then go to Liberal and go see the little Wizard of Oz house.
All right, fair enough. Thank you very much. If you'll step over here, this is Miss Kansas. Thank you very much, ladies. That completes our first five interviews.
Well, that's a pretty smooth group, and they all look so calm, didn't they? Deborah is backstage now with the girls. Let's see what's happening. Deborah?
Terry, I'm backstage here with Miss Arizona, Dana Shepherd. You've been working on camera as an interviewer. How do you think Dick did?
I think he did great. He has a great way of just making us feel real calm and confident.
He really does, doesn't he? How did you feel about your interview?
great. I just kind of felt like I was just talking to him one-on-one. It was a good experience.
Well, good luck. And I'm going to move on to Miss California, Shannon Marketic. Shannon, USA Today's Danny Sheridan picked you in Texas as odds-on favorites. How do you feel about that?
Oh, he must not have been here. Texas, I picked too, so.
You did?
Well, good luck. Good luck. Miss Georgia, Jennifer Prodgers, you had a tough question. How did you feel about that? Do you think the piece of the Berlin Wall brought you any luck?
Well, it's sitting in my sock drawer right now, so I hope it's bringing me a little luck from Georgia.
Oh, well, I think the other contestants are ready to go on now. Good luck, ladies.
Thanks, Deborah. The rest of the interviews are coming up right after this word from Max Factor International.
Very lush, very lavish, very luxurious. Max Factor International presents the very rich, moisture-rich lipstick. It fills your lips with incredible color. Silkens with 16 emollients. Moisture-rich from Max Factor International. Very original, very beautiful, very Factor.
What's the worst part of treating your worst colds?
A cold medicine that leaves me spacey.
Well, it's the cold medicine that can zonk me out. I hate that.
It's like I'm off in the ozone somewhere.
Groggy, spacey.
Introducing Sudafed Severe Cold Formula.
If it could help stop the cough and the fever, but not stop me from getting to work, that'd be great.
The first Sudafed cough, cold, and flu tablet, and it has nothing but maximum strength ingredients.
All that and it won't knock me out?
Perfect.
New Sudafed Severe Cold Formula. Maximum strength without drowsiness.
Of all the important safety features we put in the new Camry, some may seem a bit extravagant.
Stronger body construction, child protector rear door locks, rear seat headrests, adjustable front seat belt anchors, standard driver side airbag, available anti-lock brakes.
But when it came to safety, we didn't ask what it costs. We asked what it could save. The all-new 1992 Toyota Camry. We just couldn't leave well enough alone.
How does the almond get into Hershey's Kisses with almonds? Little Hershey's Kisses with almonds. Big chocolate taste.
Some people, you tell them a Lender's bagel has complex carbohydrates, 20% more than a lot of cereals people call healthy. And they still think good stuff has to come in a bowl. Well, there you go. Lender's bagels. Who knew they were this good?
Now we continue the interview competition with the remaining semifinalists, and the first is Miss Louisiana. Christy Saylor is 23. She's a graduate of Louisiana State University, now an environmental reporter, and you're an environmental writer. What can those of us in this audience, regular citizens, do to help this problem we have?
I think the most important thing is planting trees. Trees are, President Bush says that trees are the oldest, cheapest, most efficient air purifiers on Earth. Not only do trees absorb pollutants in the air, but they also produce oxygen. And I think that's the key to improving our air and cleaning up our environment.
All right, now you went backpacking a couple of summers ago, and you went all through Europe, you studied the cultures and so forth. What did you learn about yourself?
Well, I think I grew up a lot there, and my eyes opened a lot to who I really am. I learned more about myself and about my country, and I just developed more of an appreciation for the freedoms and the luxuries that we have in the United States.
Would you ever let one of your kids do that alone like you did?
Well, I went with a friend, and yes, I would. I think that it was an experience that made me mature.
All right. Thank you very much. If you'd step over here just to that little circle over there. This is Miss Louisiana. All righty, next is Miss South Carolina, Audra Wallace, who's 22 years of age from Charleston. She's on the Dean's List at Clemson University, graduated with a degree in English. Now that you've graduated, what are you planning to do?
Well, Dick, I haven't graduated as of yet. I postponed my graduation until December so I could participate in the Miss USA pageant.
Oh, well, we held you up a little bit. Now, when it does happen, do you have future plans?
Oh, yes. I plan on to obtain my doctorate degree in English and then one day find my own organization for children with disabilities and those from dysfunctional families.
Now, going from the sublime to the ridiculous, why do you have six cats?
Well, I've told others that I've had 6 cats because I don't have a boyfriend, and they keep my company. It's something to look forward to when I come back.
No. This I can't believe. I look at you, and this woman has no boyfriends. What's happened here?
Well, many men who I've spoken to said that they are intimidated by me. Either that or they are still into that stereotype that most beauty queens are unintelligent, and that is extremely wrong.
I can guarantee it. Much good luck in your search. Would you step over here, please? This is Miss South Carolina. Our next is Miss Virginia Randy Botthoff, who's 21 years of age from Fairfax. She's performed with the Virginia Ballet Company, currently a senior at Virginia Commonwealth University. You got a degree in dance and choreography. What do you do with something like that? What is your aim?
Well, actually, this past summer, I auditioned for a cruise line, and they selected me as one of their entertainers. So hopefully I'll be going this coming summer.
Will you ever put your own dance organization together and travel the country?
I'd love to someday. I'd love to have my own multicultural dance company, which hopefully someday will perform all over the world.
You said somewhere along the line you're a lot like your dad. Now, your dad is a retired military man. How do you make that comparison? What similarities are there?
Well, I think we're both really stubborn. And
is he out there tonight? Yes, we just saw him. He's smiling. It's all right.
And we're both very neat. I think that has something to do with the military. So he's a great guy, and he's taught me a lot.
Thank you so very much. This is Miss Virginia. Next is Miss Alabama. This is Candace Brown. She's a junior at Auburn University, majoring in broadcasting, wants to be an anchor woman and make a difference. How do you combine the two, a career and making a difference in the world?
Well, you have the opportunity to be in front of a camera and also to be in front of civic and community organizations. And if you're a positive role model, you can make a difference.
You said earlier along the way that you wanted to meet Boris Yeltsin. Why?
I just think that he's an outstanding man that's trying to make a difference over in Russia, and I just think that I just really admire him.
If you had the opportunity and you were to go to Russia and say had to live there for a year, do you think you could do it?
It would be hard and it would be quite an adjustment, but I think I could do it.
Are you up to practically anything?
I'm up to anything after this past 2 weeks.
Well, has this been tough? This is not a bowl of cherries?
It's just been a lot of hard work, and we've really worked up our stamina, and we've had a great time.
Thank you so much. Miss Alabama, please, if you'd step over here. Next is Miss Kentucky, Angela Hines, who's 22 years of age. She's from Maysville, Kentucky. She's a professional model. She's worked in Japan, would like to be an actress someday. Are your parents here to cheer you on tonight?
They definitely are. They're sitting right over there.
Your dad was a basketball coach for a lot of years. What, about 39 years at the University of Kentucky?
Oh, several years. Several years. He coached at the University of Kentucky years ago under Adolph Rupp, which is a very, very famous person in the state of Kentucky. Now, so we're really proud of him.
Well, coaches have a knack of telling you what to do all the time. Did he tell you what to do as you suited up for this occasion tonight?
Well, he's always been really strong, and I think he's taught me some skills in basketball, which are just to be strong and go out there and do the very best you can.
When you get back to Kentucky, what are you going to tell him about Kansas?
That it's been incredibly beautiful, and the people have been so warm and friendly, and I've just incredibly, incredibly enjoyed it.
Thank you so very much. Miss Kentucky, step over there for a second, if you will. Next is Miss Texas, Katie Young. She's 19, from Fort Worth, a pre-med major. She was selected by the People to People program to be one of 28 young Americans to serve as a student ambassador to Asia. What does a student ambassador do?
Well, we met with foreign officials and we discussed those countries versus the United States, both economically and culturally.
You know, there's been a lot of talk about American-Japanese relationships these days. They've said some not too nice things about us and vice versa. How would you improve that situation?
Well, seeing as how Japan has just paid off their national debt, I think that maybe we need to concentrate on buying American for a while.
All right. You'll get a lot of applause on that one. You have a 3.7 grade point average, fluent in Spanish. You look like a serious person. Do you ever kick back and have fun?
I love to shoot skeet, and that's a very southern, very Texas thing to do, and my father and I do that for fun just about every Sunday.
Miss Texas, thank you so much. If you'd step over there, please. Thank you so very much. 11 very interesting interviews, and that completes the interview competition for Miss USA 1992.
I have a feeling that there are a few potential anchor women in this group, and I am taking names. Let's see now how the judges rated them in the interview part of the competition. Well, Georgia ended on top in this part of the competition with a 9.671, but look how close California was, 9.629, and Alabama up there again, 9.543. Remember, this counts for one-third of the composite scores that determine now the six finalists. Coming up is one of my favorite events of the evening, a special musical salute to the Olympic Winter Games when the contestants put on their dancing shoes right after this.
From Bidal Sassoon, Ultra Care. The benefits of a shampoo, conditioner, and finishing rinse in one. The finishing rinse helps seal and protect hair from styling stress. Brilliant. Sassoon Care for salon quality hair.
This year, my buddies the mail carriers are helping Hallmark make you a hero. Just give your Valentine classic sweets. It's an exclusive collection of the finest chocolates. Then a few weeks later, Hallmark mails your Valentine a second box of chocolates. All for just $3.95 with any Hallmark card purchase at participating stores. So your Valentine feels special and you feel like a hero. Thanks to your dedicated mail carrier. Oh, and Hallmark. This year, go to Hallmark and give twice the love.
The best-selling solid antiperspirant made for tough guys like him can't keep you as dry as the one made for her. Secret Solid, stronger than his, stronger for a woman.
The Miss USA pageant will continue.
And now, the world arrives in Albertville. Saturday night, the unforgettable opening ceremonies. Sunday night, the breakneck thrills of the men's downhill, in which each man will get one chance to conquer the mountain. And the beauty and drama that is the pairs competition, where grace is showcased and gravity shattered. The Olympic Winter Games come to CBS this weekend. Let the games begin.
Imagine yourself surrounded by beauty, torn by desire, confronted by danger, seduced by deception. Now ask yourself, what would you do? What will they do?
Try me.
Try me.
Try them all, weekdays on CBS Daytime.
This is CBS.
What are you afraid of? My son asked me. They're only little bugs. Well, I don't like creepy, crawly little bugs, and the thought of them getting on me used to be a real fear. A phobia, I guess. But hey, I'm not the only one. Nearly three-quarters of us have some kind of phobia. Heights, snakes, dentists, bugs. So what can we do? Channel 10 News will focus on how to understand and overcome our fears with some fascinating and insightful tips. Phobias, what are you afraid of? Tonight on Channel 10 News, where our focus is on you.
Who's hanging right at the tower, DJ?
DHL was making express deliveries overseas before Federal Express was even in business. With a head start like that, we can simply do things others can't. DHL, faster to more of the world.
Tyson takes the stand to tell his side of the story tonight at 11.
If you could count all the titles they've won to get here, then you'd know we have a real team of 51 winners on this stage this evening. And tomorrow on CBS, you'll see another team of winners at the opening of the Olympic Winter Games. Tonight, the Miss USA team would like to send a sort of singing telegram or Valentine to the U.S. Olympic team. So park your bobsleds. Our contestants and the reigning Miss USA, Kelly McCarty, are going to lace up their street-hot miter shoes and give you a little advice on going for the gold.
You gotta have heart. All you really need is heart. When the odds are saying you'll never win, that's
when the prince should start. Zero.
Say a prayer, don't despair.
Get your chin up off the floor.
Amen, start again.
You know you can be a hero.
Stand tall, give it your all.
You can open any door.
There's nothing to it but to do it.
Nicely done. Gold medal performance. Hey, Kelly. All right. From all of us here at the Miss USA pageant to all of you on our Olympic team in France, our hearts are with you. Much good luck. Now, when we crown our winner here tonight, that'll be just the beginning of a great year for the new Miss USA. She'll travel all over the country. She'll represent the USA at the Miss Universe pageant in Bangkok, Thailand. She'll also enjoy over $200,000 worth of cash and prizes. Here's Miss USA 1991, Kelly McCarty, to show us what the new Miss USA will take home. CoverGirl, the official cosmetics of the Miss USA pageant, awards tonight's winner $7,500 plus a year's supply of CoverGirl cosmetics. CoverGirl redefines the look of the 90s with a range of products as innovative as they are beautiful. CoverGirl, redefining beautiful. She received $7,500 and a collection of Caboodles beauty organizers with clever compartments, adjustable mirrors, and fun colors. Caboodles, the beauty organizers the beauty experts use. From Catalina, Miss USA received $7,500 plus a new wardrobe of Catalina's exciting swimwear and sportswear in fresh, attractive designs and colors. Catalina, the official supplier of swimwear and sportswear for the 1992 Miss USA pageant. She wins this exciting Cobalt 20-foot Condoré sport boat with powerful V6 Mercruiser engine, convertible top, and quality Cobalt styling, plus a custom-engineered boat trailer from Shoreline Products Incorporated. Miss USA receives $7,500 cash from Pert Plus and a year's supply of Pert Plus shampoo and conditioner in one, so that her hair is always clean and completely conditioned. Pert Plus is the active woman's answer to soft, manageable hair in just one step. A fun-filled Caribbean vacation for four, or the Crown Monarch. Deluxe suites, casino, dancing, and live shows every night, plus sightseeing on four islands, all from Crown Cruise Line. From Hawaiian Tropic Sun Care Products, Miss USA receives a one-week trip to Hawaii for two. Hawaiian Tropic World-Class Sun Protection, available in over 85 countries around the world. Aloha from Hawaiian Tropic. From the Fashion Institute of Design and Merchandising, she receives a one-year college scholarship in fashion design, fragrance marketing, or merchandising at one of five accredited California campuses, plus a three-week study tour in Europe. From Minolta, Miss USA receives $7,500 cash and the incomparable Maxim 7XI SLR system, the world's most intelligent camera, plus a Minolta master camcorder and the world's only autofocus binoculars, only from the mind of Minolta. Miss USA received $7,500 plus a year's supply of Ogilvy Precisely Right, the home perm you just can't get wrong. Precisely Right by Ogilvy, the official home perm of the Miss USA pageant for the girl who is precisely right tonight. And in addition to winning a stunning evening gown wardrobe of exclusively Sherry Hill creations, the internationally famous Flemington Fur Company awards our winner a gorgeous full-length natural black glamour mink coat and mink jacket, styled for all occasions from Flemington Furs.
She received this gorgeous 18-karat gold ladies' watch studded with 56 diamonds. Awarded by Bertolucci Watch Company. Bertolucci, the finest Italian-designed new Swiss classic for the 90s. Tonight's winner of the Miss USA pageant receives an American beauty all her own. The all-new 1992 Skylark Grand Sport from Buick. The new symbol for quality in America. And finally, she receives an 18-karat gold and diamond coronation ring, created by Martin Gruber of Nova Stylings and awarded by the Midwest premier jeweler, Barriers of Wichita.
What a fantastic package of prizes. I want the car. Well, we're ready for the evening gown competition, the last semifinal event. Deborah, who do you think will stand out here?
Well, you know, watch for Miss South Carolina. There is something so lovely about her. She just glows on stage. She's so sweet. And Miss Texas, very tall, great shoulders, really knows how to carry a gown well. And don't forget, she won the preliminary gown competition.
The dancers and the models have a real advantage here, don't they?
Right, and that should help Miss Virginia. She's been dancing since she was three, so she must be at home on the stage.
This is a tough one to predict. Deborah and I have been adding the scores, and though Miss Georgia and Miss Alabama are leading, Miss California and Miss Kentucky are close behind and could take the lead if they do well in this competition. You will see all 51 contestants in their beautiful gowns.
And you may want to wear sunglasses. This could be the biggest assembly of sequins you've ever seen in one place at one time.
We'll be right back.
Next, the Winter Games are only hours away.
Before we made a driver's minivan airbag standard in the Plymouth Voyager and the Dodge Caravan, we tested it. We did the same with our available all-wheel drive and ABS brakes. And now for 1992, Chrysler introduces the world's first built-in fold-away child seat. And for this latest achievement, we'd like to thank all the little people who made it possible.
Tomorrow, the Olympic torch will complete its journey across France and arrive in Albertville for the opening ceremonies of the Olympic Winter Games. Over the next few weeks, nearly 2,000 athletes will go for medals in 12 different winter sports. You'll see them here on CBS.
The Chrysler Corporation is a sponsor of the Winter Olympics broadcast on CBS.
No.
Yes.
Oh, on your first days.
I knew I should have worn black.
Whose monthly protection hasn't failed at the worst time? Introducing new Stay Free Ultra Plus, designed to stop accidents before they start.
There's nothing like it.
New Stay Free Ultra Plus absorbs better than anything. A natural core draws moisture down, then away, so the surface can absorb again and again.
When you see it, you'll get the idea.
Even the shape is better, wider to protect front to back, edge to edge, covering places never covered before.
It's that thin and it works?
It works. Forget black.
I look better in blue anyway.
New Stay Free Ultra Plus, designed to stop accidents before they start.
What do doctors recommend most for the aches and pains of colds and flu? Not aspirin, not anymore. Doctors now recommend Tylenol, four times more than aspirin for colds and flu. Tylenol, the pain reliever hospitals use most.
Start healing your dry skin from the inside out. Introducing Jergens Advanced Therapy Lotions. New Jergens goes beyond surface healing to actually heal dry skin from the inside out. Jergens penetrates to attract your body's inner moisture, healing your skin from the inside so it stays healthier looking outside. Heal your dry skin from the inside out with new Jergens Advanced Therapy Lotions.
Who shot and killed these kids? Other kids just like them. Today in America, Bang Bang You're Dead is more than a game. 60 Minutes, Sunday.
The Olympic Winter Games. When you watch them with real refreshment from Coca-Cola products, you could win $1 million. Inside specially marked packages, you'll find a Medals and Millions game piece. To win, match the complete number any night on CBS coverage of the Olympic Games. 16 nights, 16 $1 million prizes. Let the games begin.
Since this is the third year we've enjoyed the great hospitality of Kansas, we'd like to introduce you to two distinguished guests, the Honorable Bob Knight, Mayor of the City of Wichita, and the Governor of the great state of Kansas, the Honorable Joan Finney. Thank you for joining us. And since this is an occasion for beauty and glamour, please welcome our special guests, the reigning Miss Teen USA, Janelle Bishop, and the reigning Miss Universe, Mexico's Lupita Jones. And now, the most beautiful part of the evening is our contestants set the mood for the evening gown competition.
Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of. Just the way you look tonight.
Now, during her reign, Miss USA traditionally joins her USO tours to entertain members of America's armed forces who are far from home. This tour always has a very special meaning for the young one who wears the crown, and tonight, our contestants honor our service men and women everywhere. Now, as our 11 semifinalists wear gowns of their own choosing, they'll be serenaded by the United States Air Force Academy Cadet Chorale and saluted by the United States Air Force Sabre Drill Team and the Honor Guard from McConnell Air Force Base. And now, the 1992 evening gown competition, starting with Miss Arizona.
I feel a strength that's powerful and true, as if there's nothing in the world I couldn't do. I'm way up there, up where the air is red, you're there.
Miss Georgia. Miss North Carolina. Miss California. Miss Kansas.
Still on the line.
Miss Louisiana. Miss South Carolina. Miss Virginia. Kentucky. That concludes our evening gown competition and our semifinals, and our thanks to very beautiful ladies. Thank you.
Sensational, weren't they? And the crowd sure loved them. Listen to them cheering. Let's see now how the judges scored this last beautiful event in the semifinals. They gave it to Georgia, 9.671. Alabama right up there again, though, 9.543. The hometown girl, Kansas, 9.487. But look at how close Arizona is to her. The scores are being added now, and when we come back, we will learn who the six finalists are right after this.
Tide has changed. Today's Tide is Ultra Tide.
If you have a baby, you gotta try it.
Instead of a cup, one little scoop.
I saw this tiny little scoop, and I thought, unbelievable. What can you expect with carrots planted this deep?
Today's Tide is ultra powerful, cleaning deep down inside. One little scoop cleans down to the fiber itself.
Perfect. It's out of sight.
Today's Tide is Ultra Tide.
You gotta try it.
A new American cheese snack idea. Grill it up and slice it up so little fingers can pick it up. Cut it up, fun it up, guaranteed they'll eat it up. American cheese. Kids are up for it anytime.
Okay, Ted. Here's your orange juice. You wait here, and I'll go get your breakfast.
There's nothing like 100% pure Florida quality orange juice with the vitamins, minerals, and taste that make you feel so good.
How'd you do that?
100% pure Florida quality orange juice. It makes you feel so good.
Want a hand vac that picks up more than dust? The Hoover Brush Vac has a powerful deep cleaning brush agitator. And unlike other hand vacs with messy bags, the Brush Vac has a quick release dirt cup, as easy to empty as it is to fill. The Brush Vac. Hoover invented it.
This year, my buddies the mail carriers are helping Hallmark make you a hero. Just give your Valentine classic sweets. It's an exclusive collection of the finest chocolates. Then a few weeks later, Hallmark mails your Valentine a second box of chocolates. All for just $3.95 with any Hallmark card purchase at participating stores. So your Valentine feels special and you feel like a hero. Thanks to your dedicated mail carrier. Oh, and Hallmark. This year, go to Hallmark and give twice the love.
There are 11 very anxious young women backstage waiting and wondering if they'll hear their names called when the 6 finalists are chosen. While we're waiting for the scores, let's join the reigning Miss USA, Kelly McCarty, who'd love to show you some great spots in the wonderful city of Wichita and her home state of Kansas.
Welcome to my home state. Historically, Kansas has been home to such individuals as Air Pioneer Clyde Cessna and our 34th President, Dwight D. Eisenhower. Born in the pioneering spirit of the Wild Wild West, legends like Billy the Kid, Wyatt Earp, and the Dalton Gang all hung around.
Kelly, welcome to Kansas.
Today's Kansas is not the old shoot 'em up, bang bang it used to be, but it's still right here in the middle of all that action. And Shuffler's Western Wear store will sure outfit you for the wild, wild west. Sound familiar? Home on the Range was written about Kansas. And here at the Sedgwick County Zoo on the outskirts of Wichita, all kinds of creatures still roam. Pretty good job, guys. The Little Arkansas River has always played a key role in the life of Wichita and is the center of the annual River Festival with funny floats, colorful parades, and the Twilight Pop Concert, making it a family event. Arriba! Another of Wichita's annual events is the festive Cinco de Mayo celebration.
Nowhere is Wichita's rich cultural diversity more visible than at the Mid-America All-Indian Center.
On the economic front, Kansas is a leader in the development, production, and manufacturing of a diverse number of products and services. Over 100 national corporations are headquartered in the state. Airplanes play a major role in the history and economics of Wichita. Like fellow Kansans Amelia Earhart and my mom, I could hardly wait to get my wings. If you want to give your spirits a lift, there's nothing like the speed and comfort of a Learjet. As unique as their structures, so is the research at the Pyridomes, where doctors are finding the solutions to health problems through the use of natural substances. And our future scientists can have a hands-on challenge at the Omnisphere Museum, which sometimes can be a hair-raising experience. Over the years, Kansas has been home to men and women as unique as the land itself. So that's my Kansas, a home in the heartland with a place for everyone, where the pioneering spirit of yesterday meets the challenge of tomorrow, where people still believe there's no place like home.
Thank you, Kelly. You can see why we love Wichita. Now, As our 11 semifinalists return, we're about to reveal the names of the six finalists. Thank you very much. We will not keep you in suspense any longer. Well, everybody, no, some holding hands, not everybody. All right. Here are the six candidates who will go on to the finals for Miss USA 1992. And once again, I'll name them in no particular order, okay? The first is Miss Kentucky. Miss Alabama. Miss California. We have three to go. Miss Kansas. Two remain. Miss South Carolina. The sixth name belongs to Miss Georgia. Ladies and gentlemen, the six finalists for the title of Miss USA 1992.
And terrified at the same time. I know those six girls are. They've made it to the finals, but now they are facing the next round of competition. The judges' questions, where only three will survive.
And the judges' questions are more likely to be about current events, social issues, life's dilemmas.
It really puts the girls on the spot. I know it did me.
Me too.
You know, it's interesting, Deborah, we've got some trends here with the judges. The men are scoring slightly higher than women judges. That doesn't surprise me. And Raul Rodriguez is consistently the highest judge. He likes everybody.
He's so sweet.
Averaging 9.75. David Marlowe is the lowest, averaging 9.00.
That's pretty good.
Still fantastic.
Pretty great.
However, all of these scores are now being erased, and they begin competing again on equal footing.
To keep you in suspense, you'll see the judges' individual scores, but no composite scores.
The judges' questions have been kept secret, too, so the girls have to think fast and pray they don't suffer brain lock. We will see what happens right after this word from CoverGirl, the official cosmetic of the 1992 Miss USA pageant.
Ready, Christy?
Ready.
Just when you thought you'd taken your lashes as far as you could go.
Wow.
CoverGirl takes you farther. Extension Mascara. The Lash Extender Brush and Advanced Formula extend your lashes long, longer, beyond the limits, and keep them going long all day.
A little further.
Oh, I can't go any further.
Extension Mascara. Lashes that go on long, stay on long.
Bye, Christy.
So long.
CoverGirl. Redefining beautiful.
My best friend and I went out last night with our brand new perms. Well, she had gone to the salon and spent way too much. And I had gotten an Ogilvy home perm. People kept saying to me, oh, your hair is gorgeous. But nobody really said anything to her. The Precisely Right home perm, it's got automatic shut-off timing. I couldn't have overdone it. I couldn't have underdone it. It's perfect. I'm glad I didn't go with her to the salon.
So now that you got a beautiful perm, what do you get? Ogilvy hot oil for permed hair. 1 minute once a week helps keep your great-looking perm looking great. Ogilvy Hot Oil. You got it right. Now keep it right.
Hi, I'm Tim McCarver here in the French Alps. And there's that sense of tingling excitement every time the Olympics is about to begin. The athletes are arriving, and a lot of dreams are about to come true. One of those dreamers is American sensation Bonnie Blair. You might say she's been adopted by the Champaign, Illinois Police Department. They've raised money for her by holding everything from dances to bake sales. Another set of dreamers, the American Lady Figure Skaters, led by Christy Yamaguchi. Last year, they were the first team ever to sweep the medals at the World Championships. And only one woman in the world can stop them from doing the same here, Japan's sensational Midori Ito. And don't forget the thrilling men's downhill on Sunday night. And please, do yourself a favor and join us here in the French Alps, as one of the world's truly great dramas is about to unfold.
This is CBS.
Tonight on Channel 10 News.
Boxer Mike Tyson says the beauty contestant he's accused of raping consented to everything. The ex-champ takes the stand to defend himself against charges he raped a Miss Black America contestant last summer.
The fight over breast implants tonight, women fighting for the right to make their own choice.
A sign of the times, people wanting jobs. 4,000 people in line. Well, wait till you hear how many jobs were available.
If you're afraid of heights and other phobias, don't miss a Channel 10 special report tonight to help you conquer the things that scare you most.
And one of Hollywood's biggest stars is a close call with police in Chester County. The story tonight when we join you for the Channel 10 News at 11 o'clock.
Hey, store. Your neighborhood store. You get more at Acme, your neighborhood store.
Seeing's believing, so look for these unbelievable savings at this week's 99-cent sale. New Yorker American cheese and domestic cooked ham, 99 cents a half pound. Smithfield sliced bacon, pound package, 99 cents. Brawny towels, two single rolls, 99 cents.
You get more at Acme, your neighborhood store.
At Choice Seating, we have over 500 styles of sofas and chairs and over 2,000 fabrics to put on them. And save 25 to 50% now during our winter clearance.
Now we come to the moment when our six finalists will compete to narrow the field to the final three contestants. These are the judges' questions, and each judge's name is in the bowl here. And each contestant will draw a name and respond to a question which that judge has prepared. Each contestant has 10 seconds to answer. As the judges vote for the final three contestants, they'll consider not only the answers to the questions, they'll also be reminded by instant replay pictures of each contestant's appearance earlier in both the swimsuit and the evening gown competition. Now, the score of the judge who asked the question will be highlighted on your screen. If you judges are ready, we'll begin with Miss Kentucky. Miss Kentucky, if you'll pull a question from the bowl. And this question comes from judge number 8, Kimberly Russell. Kimberly, what is your question, please?
Okay, would you rather be President of the United States or First Lady, and why?
Oh, I think definitely First Lady, because I think that it's important when you're in a marriage that you really keep your husband in line, so to speak. And I think to keep the President of the United States in line would be quite an honor. So I definitely would be First Lady.
Thank you very much. Please hold for a moment.
Kentucky has never won the Miss USA title, and right now our judges are deciding if Angela still has a chance to be the first.
Thank you very much. If you'll step back, Miss Alabama, if you'll come forward and pull a question out of the bowl. Let's see what we have here. This question comes from judge number 4, Laura Herring. Laura, may we have your question, please?
Yes. Do you think the media should print the names of sexual assaulted victims, and why?
No, I don't think that the media should print the names of the sexually assaulted, because that's when women are scared to come out because they are exploited. And I think that it's something that should be kept very quiet.
Thank you very much. Please hold for a moment.
Listen to this. The last time Alabama took the crown, she went on to win Miss Universe as well. And right now, Candace has a chance to be her state's first winner in 25 years.
All right, next is Miss California. If you'll come forward and select from the bowl. All righty, let's see what we have here. This comes from judge number 2, Chantal Cloutier. Chantal, would you please give us your question?
Would you change your mind about voting for a political candidate because of his or her marital infidelity?
Well, I think it's important that the elected official that I vote for, private standard, be as exemplary as our public stated standards are. And I just feel that that's important, so I do feel that it is my right and my privilege to know that, and I would change my mind if he was practicing infidelity.
Thank you very much. Please hold for a moment. No, don't leave.
Shannon is one of the youngest girls here, but she's handling this pressure like an old pro. If she wins, she'll be the 5th title holder from California.
Now you can go. Thank you very much. Miss Kansas, please, if you will, select your question. All right, one to a customer now. This is judge number 9, Steve DeBerg. Steve, if you will, please, give us your question.
What would you refuse to sacrifice for success?
I know I wouldn't, refuse my dignity. I probably would refuse to exploit myself.
So I wouldn't do anything that would disgrace myself or my family. I am very proud of myself and my family for my dignity, so I wouldn't refuse my dignity.
All right, hold for a moment, please.
They say it's a jinx to be from the state of the reigning Miss USA. Can Kimberly prove the pundits wrong?
Thank you very much. Miss South Carolina, would you join us, please? And we got a lot of questions still in here. All right, this comes from judge number one, Mickey Gilley. May we have your question, Mickey, please?
If you knew you could be smart or beautiful, but not both, which one would you choose and why?
I would choose to be smart because beauty is something that comes from within. And if you're smart enough to know that if you have self-confidence, then you're already beautiful.
Thank you very much. Please hold.
They call Miss USA the Super Bowl of pageants, and you can feel the tension in the air as Audra awaits our judge's decision.
All right, thank you very much, Miss Georgia. If you'd step forward, please. We've got four of these left in here, and I'll turn around. There you go. This comes from judge number five, Toller Cranston. Toller, may we have your question, please?
Yes. 100 years from today, who would historians select as the most influential woman of the 20th century, and why?
Oh, my goodness. Oh. I would pick... And this sounds kind of, but Barbara Bush, because she really keeps President Bush in line. And she is very powerful, even though we don't always see her. So I would select Barbara Bush.
Thank you very much. Please wait here a moment.
Georgia's made the semifinals 6 times in the past 10 years, but they've never had a winner. Can Jennifer Prodgers be the first?
If you'll join the others, please. Ladies and gentlemen, that completes our round of competition for our 6 finalists.
Talk about poise under pressure. Wow. Deborah, how did we ever do this?
I don't know.
I think some of these girls could enter the race for president.
You bet.
Okay, you are on the spot now. Give our viewers a prediction for the final three.
Okay. I've got to go with California because of her answer. Got to go with South Carolina with her answer. And I got to go with Alabama.
Because she has the same birthday
yeah,
as you.
Yeah, well.
Who would you choose? We'll find out if you agree with the judges when we reveal the final three contestants for Miss USA 1992 right after this.
That's a pretty good imitation.
A moment. A conversation. It shouldn't feel any different when you're talking long distance. We think you should be able to call anyone, anywhere, anytime, and still save money. That's why we invented the new AT&T Any Hour Saver Plan. We don't think you should have to make lists or watch clocks. $10 for an hour of calls anytime. Then bonus prices of just 11 cents a minute after 5, and on weekends. Because how you talk is your business. Making it more affordable is ours.
No more hairspray?
Here's hairspray that won't ever run out on you.
Vidal Sassoon hairsprays come in refills. Choose the hairspray refill or non-aerosol refill. Thanks to Sassoon, there's no more hairspray.
You know, it's really weird. We could wear the same size, but what covers you in all the right places might not cover me. Not a major problem. Unless you're talking about a maxi, now that's a problem.
But there's a solution, always with Dry Weave, for coverage in every direction and a clean, dry selection.
Ooh, this should fit.
Always protects with your choice of regular or long maxis for panty coverage front and back. And regular, long, or extra long maxis with wings that wrap around your panties for coverage at the sides.
Perfect.
Look for these symbols on every box to find your choice of always with Dry Weave that's cleaner, drier, always.
See Sunday's paper for the Wheel of Fortune Watch and Win game. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited.
Warning. UV rays in ordinary daylight may contribute to lines, wrinkles, even skin cancer. Caution. Your face is exposed to UV rays every day of your life. Oil of Olay introduces daily UV protectant. SPF 15 protection. Because over time, unprotected skin can look like this. A moisturizer so like young skin's fluid, it penetrates instantly. Important for healthier, younger-looking skin.
Now, and years from now.
New daily UV protectant.
Now, from all of those thousands of young women who began this journey months ago, we must now choose just three. Congratulations to all of you. You're all great. There's no doubt about that. But we can only pick three, so let me slip over here and we'll get to it right now. I'll read the names of the three once again in random order. The final three are Miss Alabama. Miss South Carolina. There's one remaining. It belongs to Miss California. Ladies and gentlemen, one of these three will be the new Miss USA.
Deborah, I can't believe it. You got all three.
Second year in a row I got all three.
I think we ought to go to Vegas and start a business together.
Racetrack somewhere.
The final question is next now, and the girls have to be really tense by now.
Oh, believe me, they're backstage grateful they're in long gowns so we can't see their knees knocking.
Okay, it's their last chance. Let's see what happens.
We have one last round of competition, the final questions. Actually, it's question. Only one. I'll ask the same of all three of you ladies. In order to make it fair, I'd like to ask you two, if you will please, to step into the isolation booth, play a little music, and you and I, Miss Alabama, will go over here. We'll wait for them to get in there, and I'll rip the envelope. In the meantime, it is the same question for everyone. And as soon as they're secreted in there, I think they don't hear us. If you could change anything that you did here tonight, what would it be?
I wouldn't change a thing. I'm just so happy to be up here, and I thank the Lord for being with me, and I'm happy with everything that I've done.
Thank you so very much. If you'll please step over here. And we'll ask Miss South Carolina to come out. We're asking everyone the same question, and as soon as we close the doors, here it is. If you could change anything that you did here tonight, what would it be?
Well, before I came out in the beginning, I did not say, thank you, God. And I would pray to God and bless him for just bringing me here today.
Thank you very much. If you'd step over here, please. And lastly, Miss California, had your full diet of music in there. The ears are all right. This is the same question for everybody. If you could change anything that you did here tonight, what would it be?
Well, I'm a firm believer that you can't really change anything in the past, and it's best to leave it behind and look towards the future. So I think that I would do that. I'm encouraged about what I've done so far, and I'm really pleased to be here.
Okay. Please step over here. Thank you, ladies, very much. Very nicely done. The moment of decision is here. The judges now come up with the final vote. Now, as each candidate steps forward, the judges will give each young lady a ranking. 3, 2, or 1. And as they vote for her, she'll either be the second runner-up or the first runner-up or the new Miss USA. It's time now for the final vote to begin, beginning with Miss Alabama. Miss South Carolina. Miss California. And that completes the competition for the title of Miss USA 1992.
Well, that's it. In just a moment, one of those girls is going to find her life upside down for the next year, and what a year it will be. We'll find out who the new Miss USA is right after this word.
I have just the thing for that cold.
Most kids think that medicine has to taste bad. But there's one cold medicine that relieves both kids and colds. Grape-flavored Dimetapp Elixir. Recommended most by pediatricians and pharmacists. After all, a cold medicine can't work if you can't get it down.
You like Dimetapp?
Dimetapp Elixir and Dimetapp DM for colds with coughs. Works as good as it tastes.
Listen, the same night, my mom's making chicken and stovetop. Beth Turner invites me, and she's having stovetop with the celery and onions.
So
we always eat at 6.
Yeah.
I asked Beth to make it at 8.
You can never get enough stovetop stuffing.
Hi, I'm Dick Clark, celebrating a big birthday for a living legend. It's not me. I know you may think I've been around forever, but this is 100 candles. I'm real happy to be here for the 100th birthday of Nabisco Shredded Wheat. To celebrate, Shredded Wheat is giving presents instead of getting them.
Play the Shredded Wheat sweepstakes today. There's $1 million worth of $100 mail-in certificates inside their boxes. This could be your day to win a $100 birthday present.
Hey, there's no age limit on this thing, is there?
In the next 30 seconds, you will lose 500,000 skin cells.
Skin Science Update from Vaseline Intensive Care.
I'm Joan Lennon. A hostile environment can make skin dry, flaky. But Vaseline Intensive Care research developed a lotion with 3 proven ingredients that helps rebuild the skin's outer layers, helps heal even chronic dryness. There's no better lotion to protect the 28 billion skin cells you have left.
Vaseline Intensive Care Lotion. From intensive research comes intensive care.
What's the best way to watch the Winter Games on CBS? With TV Guide's Guide to the Games, all the information and times to help you find your favorite events this week in TV Guide.
Well, the moment is almost here. We are about to crown the new Miss USA, and that means it's time to say farewell to the young woman from Kansas who's worn the crown so well for the past year. Ladies and gentlemen, for the last time as Miss USA, here's Kelly McCarty.
A year ago, I achieved my goal of becoming Miss USA, and it has been one of the most rewarding experiences of my life. From the excitement of the night I was crowned, I went on to a USO tour through Europe, which gave me the opportunity to thank the thousands of men and women who served in the Persian Gulf. I had the honor of meeting President Bush, Senator Kassebaum, and Senator Dole. There were parades and personal appearances and the chance to meet many celebrities around the country. I was proud to serve as a national spokesperson for the Boys and Girls Clubs of America, and my involvement with many AIDS awareness benefits has become a cause close to my heart. I want to thank the people of Kansas for their support, as well as the Los Angeles staff and friends at Miss Universe. A special thank you to my courageous and inspiring friend, Troy. And most of all, to my family. I wouldn't be here without you.
Thank you, Kelly, very, very much. We wish you all the very best of good luck and success with your plans in the future. And now the moment is here. The judges' rankings have been tabulated. We're about to reveal the second and first runners-up and the new Miss USA. The accounting firm of Ernst & Young has reviewed the results for accuracy. Mr. Paul Ehrenzeller will give me the results. Paul, thank you very much. Now, to assist us, we have a young lady who knows what it means to wear a crown. She is the reigning Miss Teen USA, Janelle Bishop. Ladies, they cannot go wrong. You are all wonderful, but we can only pick one. I will now announce the second runner-up. She is Miss South Carolina. If you'll come up here. Before we reveal the names of the first runner-up and the new Miss USA, let me remind you of the importance of the first runner-up. If Miss USA can't complete her reign for any reason, then that could include the possibility that she may have to give up her title if she becomes the new Miss Universe this May in Thailand. Then our first runner-up will become Miss USA. You ready, ladies? Good luck to both of you. The first runner-up is Miss Alabama. Miss USA is Miss California. Shannon Marketic, Miss California, is Miss USA. Congratulations, Miss California. You are the new Miss USA. The cash awards and the prizes are yours. You'll represent our country at the 1992 Miss Universe pageant in Bangkok in May. And now, as our entire cast serenades you, the stage is yours, Miss USA 1992. How do you feel?
I don't know.
You don't have any words?
Congratulations.
Deborah? Terry, thank you so much. Wow. See you next year. For now, Dick Clark. So long.
Of this program have been pre-recorded.
Tomorrow, the night we've been waiting for, the opening ceremonies to television's greatest drama, the Winter Olympic Games on CBS. Get ready for the grace and style of pairs figure skating, the thrills of downhill skiing, and more on Sunday. Share a moment with the world. Now get ready for your local news.